Thank you. last UNC Bassoon Studio recital. Today we have, today we have music written by bassoonists, arranged by bassoonists, written for the bassoon, and not written for the bassoon, but I think you'll come to realize that everything sounds better on bassoon quartet. Two corrections to the program. We are switching the last two pieces on the first half for logistical reasons. And the Gershwin was written in 1919. I don't know where I got 1963 from. Oh, and I'm Jessica Kuntu. I'm the bassoon teacher here at UNC. So, all right, our first piece, you may have heard of Leroy Anderson's Bugler's Holiday, but I think you'll realize that it sounds much better as this bassoonist holiday version. So, come on.
And I use she/her pronouns. I'm very excited to show this music to you today, and I'm very happy you came. Thank you. This next quartet is from Mozart's opera Don Giovanni, and it was written in 1787 and performed and premiered in Prague. A second version was then written with a slightly different score and premiered in Vienna in 1788. One fun fact about this opera is that it was the first opera to use trombone, and the score actually calls for three trombones, which is kind of crazy. In this aria, Zerlina, the female love interest of another male character, is soothing the wounds of her betrothed with her love. This opera contains quite the love triangle, but at this point, Zerlina is with her, the man she ends up being with. So thank you, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. music and statistics, and my pronouns are she, her. And Peter Schickel, often known as his alter ego PDQ Bach, is a composer and musical satirist known for many works across the classical music spectrum. PDQ Bach is supposed to be the last and least of the Bach family, and his music often parodies themes and styles prevalent in classical music. His fan base is so prevalent to this day that there is a complete PDQ Bach fan wiki page online, so look that up. This piece, Last Tango in Bayreuth, parodies music by Richard Wagner. Bayreuth is the town where Wagner created an opera house, and many of his most famous stage works were performed. He was also a bassoonist, which is cool. I mean, Peter Schickel was, not, I don't know, Wagner or not. thanks, and we hope you enjoy. Thank you.
pleasure of taking a composition class. It's advanced composition with focus on like electronics and technology. So we've all been inspired to write about and using like electronics as part of a festival that UNC has put on this semester called Ex Machina. With that in mind, my piece is inspired by, loosely by artificial intelligence, and I've decided to portray that with the electric bassoon. The electric bassoon is not completely electric, it's an acoustic bassoon with a little electric pickup. So this microphone right here goes on to the vocal, and it takes the vibrations in the vocal and puts it through with this interface that I need to turn on through my computer, where I do cool stuff with it. That makes it sound cool. I'd like to thank Dr. Kintu for being an awesome teacher, helping me get in touch with people who have made electric bassoon setups before. Dr. Weiser for helping me learn the ropes of the programs I'm using. I'd like to thank my awesome pianist, Austin Campbell. He's been awesome to work with. I'll probably be a second to make sure this is running. And I'm happy to present my piece called Year 20, Year 44. It is. Thank you.
ready for the second half? Okay. Great. Take it away.
Hi, I'm Connor. I helped arrange this piece. This is the original piece is called Lullaby for Strings, and I guess we call it Lullaby because it's not for strings anymore, it's for percent. So here, I took some notes about the piece, and so I'll show that to you now. So George Hirschman wrote Lullaby for Strings in 1919 at the age of 21 as an exercise for his private lesson teacher at the time. It became a favorite at parties that he would host over his life, but it was not publicly born in 1967, well after his death. Perhaps more interestingly though, Gershwin wrote the piece at a time where he was struggling to find his identity as a composer. In New York City, he was famous and really admired for having this jazz-influenced style, but he felt that he needed to have a more classical, traditional voice to become a truly great composer. And I think if you listen carefully, you can hear that struggle in this piece, and it will put you right back into the mind of a young, talented, and struggling Gershwin, although in 1919. That struggle is why I wanted to write this, arrange this piece. I think I'm 21, so the same age that he was when he wrote this piece, and I think a lot of us in college have experienced the struggle of trying to find an intellectual identity and have experienced that tension that goes along with that. I hope that this piece can provide not necessarily a resolution for that tension, but hope for the future, as immediately after writing this piece, Gershwin was just took his struggle all the way to Paris, where he would be inspired to write the now famous American in Paris.
high school science with a minor in music. So today we're going to be performing Adagio for Bassoon by Samuel Barber. Let me get on this up quick. So originally the Adagio was part of a three movement string quartet, and it's based off the Georgics of Roman poet Virgil. And the Georgics are poems that are based on agriculture, and they focus on the strife and tension of farming and overcoming that. And Barber captures that in this piece by having building tension, then it releases, but then it goes back to the tension again, and then overcoming challenges basically. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Bay. My pronouns are they, them, and I'm a second year majoring in music, performance, and psychology.
My name is Sam. My pronouns are he, him, and I'm a second year double majoring in neuroscience and music. Helga Werner Bollmann was born in Bremen, Germany in 1961. She studied music education, bassoon, and accordion in Bremen and Hanover, Germany. She and her husband orchestrated the children's concerts with the Youth Symphony Orchestra in Germany until 2012. Helga has taught at the Bremen Music School and the Verden District Music School for over 40 years and has been writing music the entire time. Over the years, she has written for a wide range of instruments, including oboe, flute, clarinet, saxophone, French horn, violin, and mostly bassoon. Most of her compositions are for bassoon, stretching from solo bassoon music up into full bassoon ensembles. One of her bassoon quintets is Bassoonery, which we'll be playing for you today. Helga's work in filling the music repertoire set with compositions by a woman in music has played a part in leveling the gender disparity in music, which she'll continue to do for years.
This piece is made up of three movements, each with a unique tempo marking at the beginning. The first movement, Moderato Bacchiato, uses composer Johann Sebastian Bach's name as a way to signify that this movement is intended to be in the style of Bach's work. The second movement marking is Andante Polifonic. It's a play on word of the word polyphonic, which means multiple voices, as this movement is a fugue, passing around the melody through all parts. The third movement is Presto Vivaldissimo, and uses composer Antonio Vivaldi's name in order to portray the style of this movement. Bollmann's use of these made-up words as tempo markings not only gives life and humor to this bassoonery, but allows players to interpret the piece to a degree in which typical markings would not allow them to. Hope you enjoy.
Yeah, I'm ready.
I've got middle school students, high school students, Duke students. Actually, some Duke students are putting together the reception for us right now, reception down the hall. And of course, these students, they put in a lot of extra work, many hours rehearsing and putting this together. And I think it was a lot of fun. So, looking for a I didn't talk long enough.
Hi, my name is Bart, and I am a graduate student here in Romance Studies. I'm studying French language and literature, 16th century Renaissance stuff. So that's what most of my day is spent doing, but I also enjoy coming and playing here with the bassoon studio and in the orchestra. So the last piece that we have for you today is called The Wolf and Peter. And just a couple notes about this. So in 1936, the famous Russian composer Sergei Prokofiev was commissioned by the Russian ministry to write a piece that would help introduce the pioneers, the young Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts at the time, to the various instruments of the orchestra. So what Prokofiev wrote, each character of this tale is represented by a corresponding instrument in the orchestra. The bird by a flute, the duck by an oboe, the cat by a clarinet playing staccato in the low register, the grandfather by a bassoon, the wolf by three horns, Peter by the string quartet, the shooting of the hunters by the kettle drums and bass drum. Thereby the children learn to distinguish the sounds of the instruments during the performance of this. And see, this is not that version. So, we present to you today from the Bubonic Collection, Volume 4 of the Nationalistic Quartets. This is the Bubonic Bassoon Quartets arrangement of The Wolf and Peter.
My dear children, each character of this tale is represented by a corresponding bassoon of the orchestra. The bird by the bassoon.
Oh,
bassoons and the bass bassoon. When he confronted his grandfather, the venerable old man shrugged his shoulders and muttered something about Darwin.
¶¶